I learn best by watching others perform at their best. And I wanted to teach you how to do the process of catalepsy, the process that you would use in order to create a handstand. So I went back in time and I looked through all of my footage to find three different instances where I did the process of catalepsy, and I am going to present them to you right now. Sit back, enjoy, and watch me perform three different instances of catalepsy in three different ways.
So just put your hand right there for me, and just look at, pick a spot on that hand and just pay attention to it. And just relax that hand and just notice it and look at it. And as you look at that spot on that hand, I want you to notice, bring all of your attention to what the palm of your hand feels like. And notice what that feels like. And as you're paying attention to that, notice what the pressure feels like between your elbow and the table that you're resting your hand on. And bring your attention to that sound of my voice, listening. And as you pay attention to the sound of my voice, imagining now that that hand becomes stiff. Like stiff, and you're almost surprised by the stiffness as you focus on how that palm of your hand feels. Are you focusing on that?
Yes.
Imagining that it's stiff? Mm-hmm. Now, imagining that happening continuously as you hear the sound of my voice, almost like if it's stuck completely now, and try to move that hand and it's stuck. You're smiling and it's stuck. What's happening now?
It's funny.
Right. Is it stuck?
Yes.
It's stuck. And as that hand is stuck, continuously imagine that hand is stuck really, really hard, like if it's stiff, and try to move that hand towards your face, but it's stuck. So what happened?
I can't move.
That's right. That's right. I want you to put your hand on the table. Like this.
Open, close.
Flat on the table.
Flat on the table.
Flat on the table. We're going to do something a little different.
Okay. Right hand, flat on the table.
I don't think we've ever done this. Have we ever done a hand stick before?
Not in a very long time, in a very long time. Yeah.
Okay. So what I want you to do is I want you to just pick a spot on that hand and just look at it for a moment.
Done.
Right. And what I want you to do is I want you to imagine that hand feels like heavy. Use your imagination to just feel what it would feel like for that hand to feel heavy. Are you able to imagine that?
I am.
Am?
Am.
Am? Okay. And how's that?
I am.
Imagining that it feels heavy.
Amusing.
Right. Very cool. And I want you to imagine that all by itself it feels heavy. So what it would be like for it to start to feel like as if it's one with the table. You're just paying attention to what that feels like as that hand begins to feel as if it's one with the table. So much so that that hand feels like it's stuck to the table. Now, that hand feels like it's stuck to the table now. Try to move that hand and and notice how stuck it is.
Yeah.
Stuck.
What I want you to do, I want you to put your hand right there, right? And just look at that hand right there. And just feel what it feels like for that hand right there to be touching the wall. And now as you're looking at that hand and feeling that wall, I want you to press into the wall for a moment. And as you are, notice what that feels like and imagine what it would feel like if that hand were to feel like it were stuck. Right now, stuck to that wall. Right now, that hand is stuck to that wall now. Try to move the hand and it's stuck. It's stuck. Look at me. That's stuck. What's happening to that hand when you try to move it and it's stuck?
Okay.
Try to move it. Try really hard to pull it and it's stuck. What's happening? Tell them.
It's stuck.
Like it feels like it's stuck, right? Now, in a moment, what I'm going to do is I'm going to touch that hand. And when I do, it's going to release. But something's going to happen. When I touch that hand, you're going to feel a little bit of laughter inside. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Now. That's right. Move that hand now. Right.